नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर अजीज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक रेडियल इम्यूनो डिफ्यूजन। सो देर आर टू टेक्निक्स, रेडियल इम्यूनो एसे एंड रेडियल इम्यूनो डिफ्यूजन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्यूनो डिफ्यूजन। द टॉपिक बिलोंग्स टू द इम्यूनो टेक्नोलॉजी लैब एंड द डिसिप्लिन इज फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। द टॉपिक इज रिलेटेड टू बीटेक एफबीटी 12th ट्राइमेस्टर एंड बीटेक एमटेक एफबीटी टी ग्रेडेड 12th ट्राइमेस्टर। सो व्हाट आर द इम्यूनो डिफ्यूजन? एज वी अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम द थ्री वर्ड्स, रेडियल मीन्स इट इज राउंड, इम्यूनो मीन्स इम्यून सिस्टम और इम्यून कंपोनेंट्स, एंड डिफ्यूजन मीन्स डिफ्यूज। इट इंडिकेट्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट विच इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन द डिफ्यूजन एंड वाट ऑन विच मीडियम द एक्सपेरिमेंट इज गोइंग ऑन। द मीडियम दैट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज इज अगार। ओके, वी आर यूजिंग अगार substrate for this diffusion. Agar has a particular size in which a particle can diffuse, so we are using agar in this experiment. There are two techniques which are involved in the immuno diffusion techniques. The first one is radial immuno diffusion, which is a single diffusion. Okay, in this technique an antibody is put into the gel and antigen is measured by the size of precipitin ring formed in the diffuse out in the direction from a well. Okay, and the second is outer chromate double diffusion, in which both antigen and antibody body diffuse from the wells into a gel medium. But in radio immunodiffusion, we create a well in the agar surface. Okay, we create a well, and we after creating this well, we insert our antibody, which is specific. Okay, specific antibody. And then we insert the antigen in the well for the quantitative analysis of the antigen. So what we need, what are the things which we need? The first things which we need is antibody. Okay, first we need antibody. The second thing we need is our antigen, that is our sample. Okay, it is our sample. The other thing is three standard antigens. Okay, three standard. We need some our sample that is unknown. Okay, and we need some three antigens which have a particular concentration, such as it may be concentration of 1 mg, 1 ng per ml, 2 ng per ml, 3 ng per ml, for example I'm telling, and we do not have any known concentration of this sample. Okay, so we need antibody, our sample that is antigen, and three more antigens which are known to us, which concentration is known. So, and we need the glass slide and agar. Okay, first we take a agar slide. First we take a slide and we add the agar and we create some holes, some create some wells on the agar surface. Then we add antibody, create four wells. Okay, we are creating here four wells, and after creating four wells we add antibodies in each well. Okay, first we added antibodies, then we add antigen. Okay, we add our antigen, that is our sample. Now we add standard one in the first well and standard antigen 2 in the other and standard antigen 3 in the next well. And we keep all the preparation for about 24 to 72 hours. Okay, after this thing we observe that there is a precipitation formation in the agar. Okay, we see this kind of radius around the well. So this is our well. Okay, it is our well. Okay, it is our well which containing the antigen and antibody, and we incubated it for 24 to 72 hours. After incubation we see that this antigen is showing a radial diffusion. Okay, it is showing a zone around it. It is showing a zone. We check the size of this zone. We check the size of this zone. It indicates that the concentration of this antigen is low. Okay. Similarly, in the second number antigen, that is known also, the size of zone is larger than the first. Okay. It is larger than the first, but the third number antigen, the zone is very large because it has higher concentration of antigen. So antigen and antibody react to each other and more zone is created around the well. Okay, according to this according to these antigens, okay, we can calculate the zone of our sample. Suppose the zone of sample number 1 is 9 mg. Okay, and the second number is 18 mg, and the third one is 27 mm. The zone of first antigen is 9 mm, the second one is 18 mm, and the third one is 27 mm. And on the basis of that we create a graph, and the graph showing the straight line. Okay, and on the behalf of this straight line, we can calculate the concentration of our known. Okay, we can also suppose that its zone of inhibition is 13 mm. So we can calculate the concentration of the precipitation and the diameter of the zone. So we can calculate the diameter and we can calculate the concentration of our antigen. What the antigen can be anything. It can be any hormone, it can be any enzyme, it can be protein, it can be any disease causing microorganism. Okay, so we can calculate the concentration of our antigen. So what is the purpose of the radial immunodiffusion? It is used for the calculation of a particular kind of sample. So here we, this is the method of the experiment. First we added some antigen, we added some antibodies, then we added antigen in each vial, okay, and we observed some zone around the antigen, this zone, okay, and so this is the zone of the antigen which we can calculate. Okay, we added antibodies, we then added antigen, we incubated the reaction for 24 to 72 hours. We get some zone around the wells, and then we check the diameter of this well, diameter of this zone, and then we interpret the results using the diameter of this zone. Okay, the zone is directly related to the precipitation reaction. So how we can calculate how, what is the principle behind the RID? The principle is that precipitation, because when antigen and antibody will mix to each other, will meet each other, they will create, they will form some precipitation, and this is the result of this precipitation. This zone is the result of this precipitation reaction. Okay, so we can interpret the results according to these results, that the concentration of antigen is low here, the higher. Okay, this is our sample, the first number antigen, the second number antigen, and the third number antigen, which are known. We can calculate the concentration on the basis of these standard antigen. We can calculate the concentration of our sample, okay, by analyzing the diameter of the ring. Okay, this is the result of the experiment. So first we added some our antibodies, that is the IgG, then we added non concentration such as 200, we added 200 mg, 400, 800 and 1600 mg, then we added our sample, okay, sample 1 and sample B, then we can allow the reaction to diffuse for a time. Okay, after 2 day or 3 day, we observe that there is a hollow around the vial, and as the concentration is increasing, the ring, the zone of ring is also increasing, and on the basis of these rings we can calculate the calculate the concentration of our antigen using this zone, okay, using analyzing the diameter of this zone. Okay, so next experiment will be Ottolony double diffusion test.